You can ride for fun or ride to be the fastest. And there's a rare breed of riders who do anything they want. The trial bikers. Ultimate control is what they're craving for. This 8-time world champion takes you on a journey you have never seen before. Don't miss Kenny Belaey's Bigtime Trial Adventure.
I got into trail biking approximately 17 years ago because my father, he was a motor trail biker. It was in the time of Eddie Lejeune, so I was kind of following my father's footsteps actually. Finding a trail bike at that time was like really hard. The first shop we entered to ask for a trail bike, they told us, yeah, we have one. So when we went to check that out, it seemed to be a triathlon bike. Nothing to do with a trials bike, obviously, but after searching a lot more, we finally found one, and that's how it all started.
I was 5 years old, and I wanted to get a bike, you know, like same bike as Kenny, but he was 9, so he was 4 years older than me. And I kept on nagging to my parents to get a bike, and finally they bought me one.
And I still can't believe his bike was cooler than mine.
Welcome to the birthplace of trial biking, Barcelona, Spain, the place where champions are made. Kenny will give you a quick glance into the history of the sport, the production of the first trial bikes, and we will meet the Spanish pioneers who inspired trial bikers all over the world.
In the early 80s, a Spanish motor trial champion and engineer needed a trial bike for his 6-year-old son, Arpi, and that's where my story begins.
He made a bicycle similar to moto trial, no? And then he tried to tell me what to do with a bicycle, no? And that was the beginning of the sport and also thinking about the future of mountain.
In 83, they started the Monty factory with the legendary T90 model. The bikes evolved at high speed, and many other producers copied their unique ideas. And Ott, he was the pioneer of this revolutionary sport.
17 years old, the biggest decision of my life, because I have to choose stay in the United States with another brand, stay here with my father and see the future of Monty factory, or change to motorcycle and see what happened, if I was good or not good. Finally, I stay at home and taking care about Monty factory.
Oppie really made it and had more than 12 world titles. It's great to have him as my team manager at Monty, where I can help designing the future trail bike. The most important thing on a trail bike is finding the perfect balance between strength and weight. The bike I'm riding is custom made for me, so it's prepared in a special way to ride competitions and weighs around 8.5 kg. Even holes are drilled inside to lose weight, and lots of titanium parts make this the ultimate trail machine. After getting the bike, Wesley and I headed to Barcelona to meet up with Cesar Canyas, who retired 2 years ago and is now running a trial school. Dani Comas, who I know for 15 years, is now following Ots and Cesar's footsteps in Spain.
Yo empecé empecé a hacer bike trial. Yo pienso que, bueno, vi a una gente cerca de mi casa haciendo bike trial y ya me gustó, ¿no? Pero bueno, yo igualmente, sin saber lo que era el bike trial, pues yo ya lo practicaba con una bici que no era de trial. Y yo creo que es un deporte que llevo en la sangre.
Yo he practicado este deporte, yo diría que desde pequeño, ¿no? Empecé gracias a mi padre, que él hacía moto de trial. Entonces yo tenía una moto y, bueno, siempre he tenido bicis de trial y siempre he practicado este deporte, ¿no?
De hecho, pues ahora, por ejemplo, pues no entreno tanto, cojo la bici y me noto muy a gusto con ella, ¿no? Yo creo que es algo pues que llevo dentro de mí y lo expreso de esta manera, ¿no? Yendo en bici.
Para mí ha sido, yo creo que lo partiría en tres fases, ¿no? Primero la referencia, porque digamos, gracias a él conocí este deporte, fue digamos mi ídolo. Después pasó a ser mi contrincante y después ya pues pasó a ser mi amigo y ahora mi jefe, ¿no? Yo creo que para mí en el mundo del trial pues lo ha sido como digamos casi todo, ¿no?
Al principio fue un poco duro porque siempre pues solo existía Otpi, pero bueno, después pues vieron que empezaba a ganar títulos mundiales una vez, otra vez, y bien, al final pues la gente me dio mi reconocimiento, la gente empezó a conocerme, empecé a tener sponsors, ahora después además hubo una muy buena relación con Ot. Hicimos un equipo juntos, o sea que al final pues todo acabó muy bien.
A ver, yo creo que a lo mejor al principio sí que podía tener un poco más de presión cuando era más joven. Más que nada porque pues tanto en principio como después César eran mis ídolos, ¿no? Y entonces te queda un poco de presión por intentar llegar al nivel de ellos o dejar el listón como lo han dejado ellos.
A mí siempre se me ha caracterizado por tener mucha motivación y ir muy bien de cabeza. Sobre Kenny Belaey, aparte de que hace muchísimos años desde que lo conozco, me acuerdo cuando era pequeño que siempre era el rival de Iker Lezeta, ¿vale? Y bueno, desde allí pues ha mejorado muchísimo. Lo que más me gusta de Kenny es su mentalidad para correr, en eso pienso que los dos nos parecemos bastante, y después que también es muy profesional, ¿no? Eso pienso que es muy importante. Pienso que para él es importante la competición, pero no más lo importante, ¿no? Pienso que disfruta de la competición y si gana bien y si no, pues no pasa nada, ¿no? Y aparte de eso es un buen amigo, ¿no? Lo tengo en el equipo Monty y viene a entrenar mucho aquí a Cataluña. It's two in the morning sipping with my crew. Who knows what the fuck we gon' do? Man, we got it, I'm squeezed in the shorty packing back this, she rolling with me back to my apartment, get my brains blue. But for real, be easy on my jewels. Es una pregunta difícil de contestar, la evolución, ¿no? Porque en un futuro no sabes lo que va a pasar. Ahora mismo las bicicletas que hay ahora son increíbles, ¿no? Tienen unos chasis muy pequeños, son muy ligeras, más resistentes. Pienso que se está mirando mucho el tema de las medidas, la geometría. Mike Mangler, that's my priority. Like, give me the mic, I rip that to pieces. My click form to spit sick masterpiece. It's two in the morning sipping with my crew. Who knows what the fuck we gon' do? Man, we got it, I'm squeezed in the shorty packing back. This you rollin' with me back to my apartment, get my brains blue. But for real, be easy on my
el estilo, yo creo que todo aprender un poco de cada país pues es bueno, intentar pues coger las mejores técnicas de por ejemplo los franceses o belgas, después pues de los ingleses y después de los españoles, ¿no? Yo creo que hay bastantes diferencias porque por ejemplo Francia e Inglaterra yo creo que se basan más en el 26 y España es más el 20.
Yo pienso que los que tienen más grandes cojones son los ingleses, ¿no? Pienso que últimamente con el street se están haciendo cosas muy salvajes, muy locas, que no tiene nada que ver con la competición, pero bueno, son cosas que me gusta ver y admiro. Bien, pienso que uno de los mejores consejos, pues a lo mejor no me lo dio nadie en concreto, ¿no? Pero yo creo que fue el tema de lucha por lo que quieres, ¿no? Yo en su momento luché por lo que quería, que era ser profesional, y lo conseguí en un momento que era muy difícil de conseguir y bueno, pues ahora tengo 15 años de carrera deportiva y para mí ha sido como un sueño, ¿no? Ese es el mejor consejo tal vez que he escuchado, no que me han dado.
It's comforting to see that Cesar is still involved with trials after his competitive career. He sure was one of my childhood heroes and I bet he's still going to inspire a lot of people in his school.
You're watching Kenny Belaey's Big Time Trial Adventure.
Hello, how are you?
Fine, and you?
All right?
Yes.
All right, welcome to my house. This is my first bicycle and the picture of that. He was 6 years old. Guinness Record trophies. 18 September 77, and this is my first glove, so you can see the big difference. So I keep this is one of the my first things.
You follow? We go to the area of my last day riding bicycle. The World Guinness record in Jinmao in Shanghai. I climb many stairs in 39 minutes. This bicycle is signed for very important people like Marcoma, the winner of Dakar of 2008, or Raga, Bow, Brian Lopes, or Fujinami. So it's top people, and later I make Kenny's sign here in the bicycle too. Here the signature of the all people are visiting. Here I show you the where I collect all bicycles. First Montecitas, okay. Here is a Fantic Trial, Fantic, Marvishi, Bridgestone. There's bicycles from many years ago, like 30 years ago. The most important bicycles in here is this one. This is the first Monty. It was 25 years ago. First poster of the trials. And this is Andreu Codina, this is me, Hans Rey, and this is the really beginning of this sport. Here we have Jordi Tares. All the places I have been, it's different countries. Colorado, United States, Scotland, this is Mexico, Brazil, Russia, United States, Greece, Taiwan, United States, Las Vegas, Budapest, Brussels, there. The most important thing of my life is the OTP park in Japan, no? There is one cinema, there is a BMX track, and inside a trials. And here, every night, we do some gymnastics just to keep my body.
To stay fit.
Yeah, stay fit, no?
So you don't
not,
get fat.
Not big, not big. All my remembers of all my 30 years career are inside this house. Come with me. In the bottom, you can see is all the years of my career. Every year there is picture and explanation what happened that year, from 1977 to 2008. I have my 12 titles of world championships, dancers, the maillots, the helmets, and here is all the pictures. Kenny Belaey. This is my trophies hall. It's already around little less than 1,000 trophies, and I put it all together here. And it's the first time some people shoot with the camera. From that lock, from where is the other rocks, that's my training area. Before it was good for my performance. Now it's just taking care of my body, and it's all locks, all balance, and some difficult things. The first thing I saw was this rock. Looks like a dog, and it's fantastic. I spent a lot of time here in the summertime. All the things about Red Bull that I saw in my trips, I buy or I take, and I put it here. I built these turrets, no, and for summertime we also enjoy with the pool. I like bring friends here, and okay, goodbye. Thank you.
Bye.
See you later.
After seeing Odd's place, Dani took me to the most desired training place of Spain, the Rocks of Gava. This is the place where many Spanish champions have been riding over the past three decades. For me, it's paradise. The sun, the factory, the city, the rocks, and the best teammates I can imagine. Minutes feel like hours in Belgium, but over here it's way different. Riding with Danny and Wesley is really motivating because we bounce off each other all the time. The techniques on my 26 inch are completely different from the 20 inch bikes they're using, which is a great way to fine tune our styles.
From out of nowhere, an old friend who I lately only see on TV invited us to his hidden training spot in Cava.
Hola, soy Tony Bow, estamos aquí en Gavá haciendo un entrenamiento. Soy dos veces campeón del mundo outdoor, dos veces campeón del mundo indoor.
Hello, and I'm Albert Cabestany from Spain also. We are having fun here in Gavá with our friends.
Antes de pasar por la moto, estuve compitiendo en bicicleta, creo que me ayudó muchísimo eso, hasta los 12 años. Y a partir de aquí empecé a competir con la moto y desde los 15 soy profesional.
As Tony, I started with the bicycle when I was young. I started with 5, 6 years old until when I was 12.
Yo creo que ahora hay mucho más interés en la bici de trial, es muy diferente el estilo de moto al de antes. Creo que tanto Lamping como Fujinami han tenido que cambiar un poco el estilo, ya que antes estaban delante, y de no haberlo cambiado un poco, sobre todo Fujinami, no estaría ahora con nosotros en el Mundial Indoor.
I think it's been important for Tony and me to start with a bicycle to make that kind of riding style. And what happened here is that we arrived and we would like to test things that we did in the bicycle. At the end, you need to do with the motorcycle, not with the bike.
Border Trials has been around since 1909 and has developed into something pretty big. For example, you have these factory riders with their expensive tailor-made bikes, the big professional teams, and the top guys make a lot of money. However, it's hard to compare because bike trials is still a young sport, and I'm convinced it will continue to grow in its own right as long as we keep on promoting it properly.
Años el trial me lo imagino mucho más complicado y con una gran evolución de las motos.
We have a lot of problems for going in the mountain with the motorcycle, so it's a difficult situation right now, but I think in the future they will know what we are doing and we have more help.
It's great to see that Tony and me started our career the same way and still share the same passion. My brother, who used to ride competitions with Tony, was really blown away from the big moves they pulled off. No doubt that what happened here in Europe made trials what it is today. But I believe it could have been bigger for sure. Extreme sports do usually have more chances in America, and the people I interviewed all talked about the street riding in the UK. So I guess it's time to take you there in part 2.